بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمد ونصلي على رسول الكريم أما بعد إن الله تعالى يحتج يوم القيامة بأربعة على أربعة أجناس أن day of قيامة الله سبحانه وتعالى will use as a testimony against four people with four people. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى if he does decide to inflict a servant or benefit a servant, then one should be cognizant of the fact that at no point in time, although in the sickness one has multifold benefits, it should not be exploited. It does not give one the license to disobey Allah. For example, if the time of Salat sets in, then one is required to comply with the command of Allah. If a person cannot move, if he can move his eyes only, then too salah is compulsory. So nobody on earth, no matter what excuse they have a license to transgress the command of Allah. So on the day of Qiyamah, yahtajju ala al-aghniya, the wealthy people, Allah will bring Sulaiman alayhi salam. And when the wealthy person says, Al-Ghina shaghalani an ibadatik, that Ya Allah, I was busy acquiring wealth, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell him that Lam takun aghna min Sulaiman falam yamna'hu ghinahu an ibadati. There was no person more wealthy than Sulaiman alayhi salam, and that did not stop him from obeying me. وَيَحْتَجُّ عَلَى الْعَبِيدِ Somebody may be a slave, an employee, a worker. فَيَقُولُ الْعَبْدِ كُنْتُ عَبْدًا He'd say, Ya Allah, I was a slave, I was just a worker. مَنَعْنِي عَنْ عِبَادَتِكَ I could not obey your commands. فَيَقُولُ لَهُ إِنَّ يُوسُفَ لَمْ يَمْنَعْهُ Yusuf alayhi salam, his slavery did not stop him from Allah's obedience. وَأَنِ الْفُقَرَاءُ بِعِيسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ And for those that are poor in poverty, Isa alayhi salam will be brought and it will be told that لَمْ يَمْنَعْهُ فَقْرُهُ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي That his poverty did not stop him from worshipping Allah. وَعَلَى الْمَرْضَى بِأَيُّوبِ And Ayyub alayhi salam will be brought up. Sick people will say, Mana'ani al-marad an ibadatik. Ya Allah, my sickness stopped me from your worship. It'll be told, Maraduka kana ashad am marad ayyub. Was your sickness more severe or the sickness of Ayyub alayhi salam? Falam yamna'hu maraduhu an ibadati. That did not stop him from worshipping Allah. فَلَا يَكُونُ لِأَحَدٍ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عُذْرٌ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ On the day of Qiyamah, no excuse will be accepted. وَكَانِ الصَّالِحُونَ يَفْرَهُونَ بِالْمَرَضِ وَالشِّدَّةِ And the pious predecessors were elated when sickness and hardship came to them. For many of the reasons which have been highlighted, and لِأَجْلِ أَنَّ فِيهِ كَفَارَةً لِلْذُنُوبِ And it was an opportunity for their sins to be forgiven, their stages to be elevated. Amongst the amal which has been highlighted in deen is the miswak. السِّوَاكُ مَطْهَرَةٌ لِلْفَمْ وَمَرْضَاتٌ لِلْرَبِّ That if you want to cleanse your mouth and find the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then use the miswak. الروايات مجلات للبصر and it strengthens the eyesight. The virtues of the miswak cannot be overemphasized and over highlighted. Nabi alayhi salam has said, make sure you utilize the miswak. ما جاءني جبريل إلا وأوصاني بالسواك. Almost every occasion that Jibreel alayhi salam came to me, he emphasized the usage of the miswak. Hatta laqad khashitu ay yufrada alayya wa ala ummati. So much importance was highlighted that I feared it would have been made compulsory on myself and my ummah. ولولا أني أخاف أن أشق على أمتي. If I did not fear that thus miswak would not have been difficult for my ummah to follow, لفرضته عليهم. I would have made it compulsory on my ummah. لأستاك حتى خشيت أن أحفي مقادم فمي. I used to utilize the miswak so much that I feared that I may lose my teeth. لقد أمرت بالسواك. I have been encouraged and commanded to utilize the miswak. حتى خشيت أن يوحي إلي. I was afraid any time revelation would come down and it would have been made compulsory. لولا أن أشك على أمتي. For his purposes and not to make it difficult and hard on my ummah, if I had the option, لأمرتهم بالسواك عند كل صلاة. I would have commanded them to utilize the miswak on every salah. Another riwayat, لأمرتهم ما أكل وضوء. I would have commanded them to utilize it on every wudu that they would make. ركعتان بالسواك أفضل من 70 ركعة بغير السواك. Two rakats performed whilst a person had utilized the miswak is more virtuous than 70 rakats performed without the miswak. وفي ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون. We hear the importance, we know the veracity which Nabi alayhi salam has highlighted. We hear how much benefits they are in, but it is up to us how much yaqeen a person has and how much love we have for Nabi alayhi salam and for Allah, that a person even without hearing the virtues and knowing it is not farz, yet he will practice on it. تأسل إله وأنت تظهر حبه. You say you love Allah, you claim that you love the Nabi of Allah, you make big statements, bold statements, claiming that you love Allah and His Rasul, yet your every action is contrary to their commands. هذا محال في القياس بديع. This is impossible. There is complete contradiction to your statements. لو كان حبك صادقا لطعته. If you are genuine in your claim that you love Allah and His Rasul, then your every action would be compliant to His commands. إن المحب لمن يحب مطيع. That a lover fulfills the instructions of his beloved. Whoever you love, you will comply and you will follow exactly what they say. You say you love Allah, but your life is contrary. So much emphasis. One needs not to know how much it has been emphasized. Maulana Jamshid Rahmatullahi Alayhi, it is said he came into the work of Tabligh. Once he went into the masjid and in the wudu kana, he seen one Mewati very stressed and parishan in grief. So after a while he noticed him looking for something and he asked him that, what's the reason for your stress and grief? So this Mewati said, I came to make wudu and I didn't find my miswak. What will be the condition of my salat without miswak? Maulana said, that was sufficient for me. That was a means for him coming into the effort of tabligh. That this is an ordinary person who hasn't heard the fadail and the virtues like we as ulama have heard it in Quran and Hadith. Yet, he is so restless. There must be something in this effort of tabligh which has instilled this restlessness in him. How much salat has passed of my life that I haven't read the miswak and there was not a grin on my forehead. Yet, he is worried. So, when a person has this ambition and desire in their heart, then there's no need for long, long lectures and long, long bayanat. فَضْلُ الصَّلَاةِ بِالسِّوَاكَ لَالصَّلَاةِ بِغَيْرِ سِوَاكَ سَرِينَ ضِعْفًا 70 times. Musalma says, I seen Zaydan yajlisu fil masjid wa inna siwak min udhunihi mawdi' al-kalam min udhuni al-katib. That I seen Zayd radiallahu an in the masjid, and like how nowadays people put the pen in their ears, they were so particular about remembering about the miswak and utilizing the miswak that they used to keep it on their ears. There's also the habit of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu that he used to keep his miswak there, and he used to utilize the miswak often. Ibn Umar says, Nabi alayhi salam, as much as 4 times before salah, the miswak was utilized. فَكُلَّمَا قَامَ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ اسْتَاكَ. And every time they used to stand for salat, they used to utilize the miswak. إِنَّ أَفْوَاهَكُمْ تُرُقُ الْقُرْآنِ وَطِيِّبُوا بِالسِّوَاكِ. That the mouth is the avenue for Qur'an. So cleanse your mouths with the miswak. إِنَّ الْعَبْدِ إِذَا تَسَوَّكَ ثُمَّ قَامَ يُصَلِّي. When a person utilizes the miswak and they get ready for salat, قَامَ الْمَلَكْ خَلْفَهُ, there's an angel that is ready in preparation before him. فَيَسْتَمِعُوا لِقِرَاءَتِهِ, he listens attentively to his tilawat. فَيَدْنُوا مِنْهُ, and he comes close to him. كُلَّمَا كَرَأَ آيَةً أَوْ كَلِمَةً نَحْوَهَا. Every time he recites a ayah or a verse, حَتَّى يَضَعُ فَاهُ عَلَى فِيهِ, and he puts his mouth on the mouth of the qari. فَمَا يَخْرُجْ مِنْ فِيهِ شَيْءٌ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ إِلَّا صَارَ فِي جَوْفِ الْمَلَكِ. Every word and utterance that emanates from his mouth, it is secured in the stomach of this angel. فَطَهِّرُوا أَفْوَاهَكُمْ لِلْقُرْآنِ. Make sure you cleanse your mouths with the miswak for Qur'an, for salat, for tilawat, for ibadat. So we should make it a habit, we should make it a routine. Never ever should a day pass where we don't utilize it. Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimahullah say, if the inhabitants of a city reject the use of the miswak, then it is necessary for the hakim, the ruler, to wage war and battle against this person, like how a hakim should wage war against those who become murtad and renegade. He should wage war, same war that is declared against the enemy. The Sha'ran rahimahullah used to say that a pledge has been taken from us on the behalf of the Nabi of Allah that we should be steadfast. We've heard the hadith and the fadail, and we have taken a pledge to utilize the miswak at the time of wudu. If it happens such that one forgets, then even if he has to take a string and hang it around his neck or hang it on his turban, he should exhaust every avenue to make sure that the sunnah does not forgo and passes him. Shaykh Muhammad Rahimullah used to say, over 100 ahadith have been narrated regarding the significance of the miswak. He said, how amazing and astonishment, and I am perplexed at mankind, at humanity, that they can neglect such an important sunnah that has been highlighted by Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The times it should be used, whether it's recitation of Quran, recitation of ahadith, cleansing of the mouth, learning, teaching of deen. When a person wants to make the dhikr of Allah, when one enters the house, leaves the house, that's in an average, if he's going for salat or work, at least 5 times 2, 7 times 2. Then, when he enters a good gathering or departs, when he experiences pangs of hunger or thirst, at the time of death, at the time of sari, before every meal, after every meal, before undertaking a journey, on returning from a journey, before sleeping, upon awakening, on Jummah, on fasting, on every wudu, on every salat, on a time of tahajjud, if we calculate it, at least 40 to 50 times daily a person should be utilizing the miswak. It's all about yaqeen. An ordinary housewife makes sure she puts all the ingredients so that the meal is complete. Yet, on our deen, when it is naqis and incomplete, how restless are we? There's no salt in the food, how restless. If the clothing gets a burn, how angry do we get? If a glass breaks in the house, how angry do we get? If there's a scratch on our car, how restless do we get? If there's a mark on a person's face, how perturbed does a person get? Yet our deen is tarnished, how restless do we become? For our children to go to school and get secular education, how restless do we become? It is all about the yaqeen that we have. Ibn Abbas said that Nabi alayhi salam used to use the miswak at night time every 2 rakats of tahajjud. Al-Lama'ini has recorded it is mustahab to use the miswak on every 2 rakats of tahajjud. Allama Ibn Ismail says, it surprises me how people leave such a great sunnah, yet it has been highlighted and emphasized so much in Quran and Hadith. So we should not pass a day without making amal, and the amount of shifa and benefits in utilizing the miswak, Allah give us tawfiq of life, an opportunity to do it. The amal for today is that Nabi alayhi salam, when he used to enter the masjid, the masturat in their place which is stipulated as a masjid, the men in the masajid, أَوْذُ بِاللَّهِ الْعَظِيمِ بِوَجْهِ الْكَرِيمِ وَسُلْطَانِهِ الْقَدِيمِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. A person when he enters the masjid should read this dua. فَإِذَا قَالَ ذَٰلِكَ قَالَ الشَّيْطَانِ حُفِظَ مِنِّي سَائِرَ الْيَوْمِ. In the narration of Abu Dawood, Shaitan says, now he's been protected, he's got an invisible shield from me. May Allah give us tawfiq of making amal. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.